This is my life, guys. This is my life. Hey everyone, welcome back to another video of Little Customs. Today we are on a little bit of an adventure. We're actually on our way back from the adventure. As you guys seen in the beginning of the video, we actually viewed a car from my buddy Kyle of Racebred. And the reason being is because one of my friends is actually in the market for a car, so we're actually checking out the car, checking out the budgets as well. Car's a very, very nice car. If we do not take the car, definitely send me a message on Instagram if you guys would be interested in the specific car. I'll send you guys all the details. That is if we do not take the car for my buddy. We actually picked up the merchandise from Racebred, aka Kyle and his brother Dylan. So if you guys did order merch from Late Late Company, keep in mind, I know there has been a little bit delayed, but we are in the process of sorting out all the orders and getting it like packaged up and sent out and ready for collection. But I hope you guys enjoy the road. We need to drop off the GTI reel here soon as well for detailing, because you guys know we are in the process of like prepping the car to be sold. We do not have a buyer as yet, but if you guys are interested in the car, don't forget to send me a message at Little Customs and I'll send you guys or forward all the details to each and every one of you guys actually interested in the car. So I have to overtake here real quick, but enjoy the road. Strand's weather is quite cold. It's not cold, but it's like very, very musty. Can't get focused, but it's quite musty. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the road on our way home. I just stopped here at Wilma's house. Wilma's gonna do a 3-stage detailing on the car. If you guys in need of his service, I link his number is down below, so I'm just gonna come pick him up and then he's gonna drop me off at home and come home with this car. So hopefully at the end of today's video I can actually show you guys the results on this car, because this car actually looks very, very filthy. There's like a lot of scratches on and stuff like that, so he's gonna sort out all that for us today. I just finished up editing today's video, as you guys can see right there. Unfortunately it's a little late, but the day has been very, very packed. Yeah, we got the merch, in the other room, so I'm just gonna unpack that for you guys and show you guys how the merch looks like. Here we got the caps, we got all the t-shirts, the hoodies. Here we have the white t-shirt with the black printing as well as the black patch in front. So this is the rear side, so meaning your pack, and this is obviously the front right here. So that is the white t-shirt. This is the black t-shirt with the white printing on and the white logo in front as well. And this is the grey t-shirt, which is the old design. This is actually for William, because William wanted the old design. And it is optional. You guys can either choose the new design, which is this one right here with the yellow thing at the back and stating Late Late Customs, and then you have the old design which just says Late Late Customs at the back with the older logo in front. That is the older design. And here we obviously have the new design hoodies. New design hoodies are exactly the same like the t-shirts, with the patch in front and the yellow thing at the back. The black hoodie comes with the white printing, and the white hoodie comes with the black printing, and then the grey hoodie comes with the black printing as well. As you guys can see right there in front, you have Late Late Customs here on your left arm, and at the back you have the other thing as well printed in black. So this actually came out quite dope. I'm extremely happy with this specific merch launch. I know you guys actually asked for some Honda merch as well, so I'm actually currently working on that. I'm supposed to well send over my designs by month end, so hopefully middle next month I can actually release a Honda design for all the Honda owners out there that would like to purchase some Late Late merch. Then obviously we have the caps right here. This is the grey cap, the black cap, and these two are the baseball caps right here. And obviously I have the flat cap. When I actually ordered the caps the first time, I also wanted the baseball cap. This is my personal cap right here, but I definitely need to order a baseball cap for myself as well. And the grey actually looks quite dope. I really like the grey, so I think I'm gonna order me a grey baseball cap. And this is the black baseball cap. We do stock white baseball caps as well, and we do stock the flat base cap if you guys would be interested. If you guys did not know this, where you can actually order merch, you can order merch from my WhatsApp number if you guys do have my WhatsApp number. If not, you guys can contact me at Late Late Company. I'll link it on the screen for you guys to order or place your merch. All merch orders will only be placed through once the payment has been made. Unfortunately, that's how it works, because if I don't follow this specific method of trading, then I will be more left with stock that will never sell in, well, a variety of sizes. So that's the reason why I usually ask for your sizes, the type of t-shirt you want, and the type of color and all the specifications. And then once you made your payment, I can actually send everything through to my supplier, and then from there you can actually well receive your order within 2 weeks to a month's time. The stickers are also available, like stickers and caps I will stock, but anything regarding to sizing, unfortunately I won't stock. So if you guys would like a t-shirt or a hoodie, you guys will need to pre-order those with the payment of your order. And the stickers, unfortunately, are not yet. Still need to go and collect the stickers by Sticky Lego. So I will do that a little bit later in the week to make sure that everyone actually gets the order early next week. Wilma just finished eating the parcel. Gonna collect that real quick. As you guys can see, the car came out amazing. Walmart did an amazing job on this car. There were a lot of scratches on this side right here. Got it out completely, only like a few deep scratches was left on the body. But other than that, the car came out amazing. Check that mirror finish right here. So this car is basically ready for, well, the next owner. It's very sad to see this car go. Didn't really want to sell the car, but it is what it is. And like I mentioned, if you guys want to make use of Walmart service, I'll link everything in the description down below. We didn't really do anything productive today. This is literally like a really night. So the time we were actually hanging at the back, it was like, well, load shedding, so you couldn't really like see much on camera. But well, we're gonna eat. It's like 8:30 the night. Today actually I took a little bit off because I didn't feel like working, because I was completely exhausted of this past 2 days. So I will check how this video goes. I think I'll rather pick up the video again tomorrow morning to finish up on Gary's car, and then yeah, we'll get that sorted and we know we've made at least some progress in this video. So I'll see you guys tomorrow morning. This is day two. We are gonna finish off this 180i right here, Gary's car. We're gonna start off by installing the speedo sensor, checking if it works, and if this works, then we need to get the air filter box in the car. Once again, we need to remove the front bumper to get this light out, seal up this light, make sure it doesn't fog up like this again, and get it nicely polished up. And then the last thing we need to do is check out why the blower wasn't working, because I checked it out the day we went and purchased the car. seems like the blow is not plugged in, like it's bypass or something, so I just need to check if it works. So let's get started. We got the car checked up. The only thing left to do is test out if the speedo sensor works. We got the speedo sensor in, we got it plugged in as well, so now we have to put the sensor to the test and check out if it actually works. Seems like the speedo sensor does not work, so we'll have to check if the terminals are properly connected to the plug, and we'll basically take it from there. I'm not entirely sure if you guys can see this, but this is the plug that goes into the speedo sensor right here. And if I deepen the center one, this plug alone looks a bit well broken off, because that speedo sensor laying there in the table's middles, like pin was broken off, so I think they must probably broke off each other. So what I did do, I actually purchased normal terminals. So what I need to do, I need to cut off these wires from this plug, fit the normal terminals, and just fit it in the correct order in the sensor, which I'll just figure out real quick for you guys. The blue wires on the right, the black with the yellow stripe is in the center, and then the other black wire, the plain black wire, is on the left. So I hope that helps you guys. I'm just gonna do that on the timer for you guys real quick. Tape 2, see what it does. I see a slight movement there. There we go, there we go. Now it seems to work. We're on a dyno right here, guys. Be very careful when doing this. The car is currently on jack stands and on jacks, so be very careful when doing this. Well, now we know that sensor works. We're currently busy with the blower, so I got the blower removed. If you guys do not know where the blower is located, it's literally located in this section right here, behind your cubby holder at the bottom. It's screwed on with 3 screws. You can literally just unscrew them, release this tap, this clip right here. This is the clip to make the blower functional, to clip it in. So I'm gonna leave it in at the time to actually get it tested out, because this was not plugged in at all. And looking at the blower, I could see why it was not plugged in. So I personally don't think this is the right blower for the car, or this blower was in the car for the condition the car's in. So the people definitely, the previous owners of this car really did do something to this car to make it end up the way it is at the moment. So I'm just gonna show you guys, it only works on 4 for some reason. I have no idea why, but just hear the noise this blower actually makes when I put it on. I'm gonna get the camera nicely located for you. Let's check it out. You guys can see right here. Let's check if I put, this is off 1, 2 bar, 3 bar, and this is 4 bar. You see that sound right there, it makes. So I'm maybe just gonna put it in and see what it does, but definitely needs to be replaced. I'm just gonna tell the owner to replace this one time. I don't think it's too expensive, because a lot of people are stripping EKs nowadays. Got the blower back in, but listen here guys, this is what the blower in the car. Nobody wants that sound underneath the dashboard, so we definitely need to get a new one and then solve that problem. I don't think it will be too expensive to source one, but if any of you guys out there maybe have a blower for sale, definitely do hit us up, because my friend actually needs I blow off the car. Like, the condition of this car is like so amazing. Like, it's such a nice car, but they obviously, like, a few stuff, well, they got neglected throughout the previous owners. And like, it literally sucks, like, how people could literally, like, a little car dealer. If I can state it that way. So we're doing our best to actually rescue the car. And this car actually needs to go, well, to Tanu to get, well, the head done. Because I'm going to be completely honest with you guys, this, well, I'm not going to tell you who did this on the car. They use copper spray on the head gasket. The car's exhaust is, well, pushing out water. So meaning it's busy, or it's in the process of blowing its head gasket. So now we're gonna rather take the car to Tana one time and get that sorted as soon as possible, so I know the owner of the car is actually completely happy with the car. Other than that, it's a very, very nice car, but all I can say, of all what I feel, is that whoever did this to the car knew exactly what they are doing, because the next owner needed to do a lot to the car to get it sorted out. But at the end of the day, it's still a very, very neat looking car, and the current owner of this car is definitely going to pull this car together. So I feel personally we sorted out a lot in this car while the car was here at Lakeland Customs. And now we all need to do is the head. Well, if it wasn't for the head, the car would have been like, say, like 80% like alright, because I did do the suspension, which I didn't film. I did service the vehicle as well, and the shocks are done on the vehicle as well. But the owner definitely would like to purchase coilovers to lower the car in the future, so he's rather gonna save up for some coilovers. The car's going to Tana for the complete head gasket, and for the water system, we're gonna do timing belt tensioner, water pump, the water system. He's gonna do oil again. He's gonna do a new head gasket, and obviously valve cover gasket and stuff like that. You know how it goes. And Tana's gonna do the trailing arm pushes as well. So if you guys do want to do trailing arm pushes, definitely head out to Tana, because Tana does a simply amazing job. I will actually film or like do a short video of while I'm there with him to show actually what he does. Once again, if you guys do not know, Holloway's Workshop. That will be all for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys did, don't forget to smash that like button. This is another, well, complete day. I started this video off through the day, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below what you guys thought of the entire process of like the daily vlogs kind of vibe. And well, these lights came out amazing. As you guys can see, this one I sealed up, this one I just polished up. Came out amazing. This car is really, really coming together. And I'll definitely film the vlog of us dropping this off at Holloway's workshop. I'll see you guys in the next one.